Hello students, in this video we are going to see a composition. Okay, let's see the definition given for composition. The nature of something's ingredients or constituents, the way in which a whole or mixture is made up. This is what the definitions are given for a composition. Example, the social composition of villages. It's a mixture. Like that, constitution, structure, construction, arrangement, organization, format, layout, all these comes under the name composition. It's a creative work, especially a poem or piece of music. Example, Chopin's most romantic compositions. It's a work of art. Composition is a work of art, a creation. A literary, it may be a literary or musical, it may be an artistic work. Poem, novel, play, symphony, concert, painting, drawing, picture, everything comes under composition. So, the composition has such importance. While writing the composition, we have to take much care. Yes, in composition, we are going to learn the leave letter writing. How a leave letter should be written. First of all, we shall learn about letter. The letter is divided into two. One is formal letter and another one is informal letter. In other words, a formal letter is known as official letter and informal letters are personal letters. Yes. And the leave letter. For two kinds of reasons we may take leave. One is planned leave, another one is unplanned leave. Okay, planned leave in the sense the leave taken for attending a marriage functions, festivals, tours and travels, etc. Because we know the dates of these functions or marriage, festival or anything. Unplanned leave, unexpected things in life like illness, disaster. Okay, yes, a letter should have the following parts. What are they? Date and address of the writer, address of the recipient, the salutation or the courteous greeting, and the salutation or the courteous greetings for a formal letter would be sir, dear sir, respected sir or respected madam. The salutation or the courteous greeting for an informal letter would be my dear father, my dear uncle, my dear friend, etc. Fourth one, the body of the letter, the main content. Fifth one, the subscription or the courteous leave taking. If it is a formal letter, means yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours truly or yours obediently. And if it is an informal letter, means yours affectionately or yours lovingly. And the sixth point is the signature. Okay. And the seventh part is the address on the envelope or the superscription. This is needed for the letters to be sent by post or couriers. C. For the letters which we are submitting in person, we don't need this address on the envelope. For example, the live letter which we are submitting in schools. We are going to submit the live letters in person. So, there is no need for address on the envelope for the live letters. Only for the letters which are to be sent by post or courier service, the address on the envelope is needed. Okay, this is the question for the first composition. Write a letter to your class teacher requesting leave for 3 days to attend a wedding. So, for attending a wedding, we need 3 days leave. For that, we have to write the leave letter to the class teacher. Yes, how we can write? It is a planned leave letter. Okay, the first thing to be written in the leave letter is the date and the place. This is the first step. Place and date. Okay, what is the second step involved in letter writing? Writing the from address. We have to write our name, standard and section, our school name, the place name, Pudukottai. Okay, this is our second step. And what is the third step? Writing of the to address, the class teacher, standard and section, our school name, place name. Okay, students, you should mind that in from and to addresses, near the word from or near the word to, we should not put any full stop or comma or semicolon, anything, semicolon, etc. We should not put any such marking. Okay, so writing that to address is our third step. Okay, what is our fourth step? After completing from address to address, we have to give the salutation. Respected sir or madam. If your class teacher is a male staff, means write respected sir alone. If your class teacher is a female teacher, means write respected madam. That's it. Don't write respected sir / madam together. Okay, this is our fourth step. And the fifth step, or the important part of the letter, is the content. For what we are taking the leave. The content is the main thing in a leave letter. Okay. This is our fifth step. So, in the content what we are writing, I will not be able to attend the class. Okay. So, the letter is in future tense. Okay. Because we are going to take the leave from July 16 to July 18 as I have to attend a wedding at Chennai. Hence, I request you to grant me leave for these 3 days. Okay, the next step involved in this leave letter writing is thanking you. Writing thanking you. And What is our next step involved in this is the subscription or the courteous leave taking. Yours obediently. This is our 7th step. Okay. So these steps are involved in writing a leave letter. Okay, so this is the complete leave letter. Place and date, from address to address, salutation, content, thanking you, yours obediently. Okay, let's see the second type of letter, which is for unplanned leave. For example, the question. Write a letter to your class teacher to excuse you for not attending classes. State reasons. Due to illness, you may not have attended a class. For that, we have to submit the leave letter after taking the leave when we reach the school. Okay. Like our first letter, we have to write everything, place and date, from address to address, salutation, and only the content will be changed. I was unable to attend the classes yesterday. We have to write the correct date. As I was not feeling well, kindly excuse my absence. Okay. After that, thanking you, yours obediently. Okay, this is the leave letter for unplanned leave. Okay, thank you students. Have a nice day.